everybody. Okay, so now I'm going to pick up where the last video left off. We were talking about my book of herbology that I am contemplating on putting together in this particular fashion. And the reason why I chose to do this is because, for me, of course, there's so many books out there with all kinds of information on herbs, and that's fabulous, and I still reference to that and will all the time. But what I really wanted to do is I wanted to have a book that was exclusively my own with information that I have compiled using the specific herbs and their medicinal and spiritual properties that I particularly enjoy working with. So this is the book right here, and as I showed you before in the previous video, and it has all of these pages in here of which you would put photographs. So what I have done, and I'm probably going to have to come back to this video at another point as well, because I'm not completely done with this book, and I think that there might be some interest, as far as what I'm hearing, on what it actually looks like when I'm finished with the book in itself. But in the meantime, this is what I have done so far. You'll see right here is a stack of papers. I have a couple of information pieces that I've already written. But this is just a stack of papers, and this is index cards. They're blank index cards that I purchased. They're blank on either side, and you can get them with the lines too, because in this particular book, the way that it goes into each slot, you're not going to see the back of it anyways. Even if you did see this slot on the other side, you could put another card behind it. So it's really up to you how you want to work it, but I decided to go with these. And what I did was I aged these papers. So you can see the whole stack right here. They look so fabulous. And I'm trying to remember if I did a video. Oh, no, I didn't. But on my blog, The Enchanting World of Miladyleela, I have shown a blog post where I did I've aged these papers. And all that I did was I tea-dyed these, and I soaked them in a tea bath. And then it might have even been a coffee bath. I can't remember offhand. Either way, it really doesn't matter. You can either age papers with tea or with coffee, and it works out the same way. I think that if you decide to use tea, you're going to have to let them sit a little bit longer because the tea isn't quite as dark and staining as the coffee. So if you want it to go a little bit more quickly, you might use coffee. In any event, what I did was, in this particular blog post that I shared, is I soaked them, they were completely wet, and then I dried them in my oven on a very low oven setting, and I think it was about 250. So if you kind of search back through my blog and maybe type in the search about aging and coffee staining papers, you will probably come up with that. If you're interested, and after you've already tried to search it and you can't find it, just leave me a comment below and I would be more than happy to go ahead and try to search for you. But in the meantime, it would really help me out if you did some of the research yourself. And I'll be more than happy to jump on there and search for it if you can't find it. Not a problem at all. Anyways, so that's what I did. I aged all of these papers, and then I started writing on just some notes here, and these are just a few pieces of papers that I've written notes on particular herbs that I was working with. And truthfully speaking, it's probably not a good idea to go ahead and write it on one piece of paper and then transfer it to the next piece of paper, because that would take a lot of time. So really what I would encourage you to do is to just go ahead and write it on your papers after they have been aged and dried. And you can do some decorating at the tops if you want with pen or markers. You could even take your decorative scissors and you could cut little shapes. And then go ahead and write the information that you want onto the papers and then insert them into your book. So I know that not everyone's going to have a book specifically like mine. But if you go ahead and research, well, not really research, but just like when you're at the store, just go ahead and check the section where they sell photo albums, or at the thrift shop where they, you know, you find a pile of photo albums or scrapbooks, anything like that, you can create and make your own herbology book. So right now, one of the books that I'm using that I'm really excited about in getting this information compiled, in addition to information that I've found on the internet, but this book is a book that I had requested for Christmas last year, and Jimmy got it for me, and he always usually gets me everything that I want when I request certain things like this, and so I was really excited to receive this. And this is Cunningham's Encyclopedia of Magical Herbs, and it is by Scott Cunningham. And you've probably seen this before if you are interested in herbology like I am. And inside, it just has a wealth of information about different herbs and their uses. So that's one of the books I'm using, among others, that I have collected and compiled and have been gifted. So I'm in the process of putting this book together. I'm really excited about how it's going to turn out. And when I am done with it, I will go ahead and do another update just to show you what it looks like. And perhaps some of the herbs that I've decided to put inside my book also. So, I hope that this video has given you some inspiration on how you can go ahead and collect information and store your information on the herbs that you choose to work with in order to create your own book of herbology. Thank you so much for watching. I am so happy that you come back each and every time. It really means a lot to me. I love making videos for all of you, and I hope that they're inspiring. I hope that you're loving them as much as I love creating them for you. So thanks again for watching. Have a beautiful and magical day, and I will see you in my next video. Until then, many blessings. Peace.